This is Toyota's factory. Well, many, many years ago. At that time, it would take Toyota days to create one car. This is because their productivity levels are low and it greatly affects their output levels. Even their workers don't look motivated. Toyota were very worried about their productivity levels, which led them to think, how can we integrate both people and technology to increase our productivity levels? The system Toyota came up with turned out to be a world changer. For the idea to function well, people and technology must integrate in a system, exploiting the strengths and minimizing the limitations of each component. It is very important that both components work closely together to maximize the potential of the system. The first component is people. The most important aspect of integrating Toyota's system is the human element. Everyone in the company is not only encouraged, but expected to participate in, contribute to, and help develop the process. They call this strategy Kaizen, which means never-ending efforts for improvement. Core values of Kaizen include teamwork, personal discipline, quality circles, improved morale, and suggestions for improvement. This will not only improve Toyota's employees, but also the productivity of the organization as a whole. Next component is technology. Toyota uses the pool-based model, which is under the demand-driven supply chain concept. They name this system of theirs Just In Time. The main idea of this model is to make what we sell and not sell what we make. This will enable Toyota to eliminate waste, inconsistencies, and unreasonable requirements on the production line. This system will not only help them to reduce unnecessary costs, it will also make Toyota both effective and efficient in terms of productivity. Being able to successfully utilize knowledge management system has given Toyota a keen competitive edge in the automobile industry. At the end of each work week, groups of Toyota production workers gather around to identify actual or potential problems in quality, productivity, and safety. However, it's not always possible to fly across the world to see what's happening. That's where collaborative tools come in play. Through such discussions, Toyota employees share their ideas for improvement, devise steps to test new ideas, and assess the results of their tests. With the help of collaboration tools, Toyota is able to maximize their collaboration not only within the manufacturing plants in Japan, but also with plants and branches all over the world. This will enable them to communicate even from a very far distance. They are able to spontaneously make decisions through email, web conferencing, screen sharing, and video conferencing. Productivity, quality, and innovation can be obtained when ideas of Toyota are shared all over the world. With the help of the concepts mentioned previously, Toyota's workers become more motivated and productive. That said, with the same amount of workers, Toyota can double their productivity. Can you imagine having thousands and thousands of these productive workers in Toyota? Forwarding back to the current Toyota, with the help of both people and technology, they will take much lesser time to create one car. Comparing to the previous scenario where they take days to complete a car, they currently are capable of creating one car in only 20 hours. With the help of increment in capital and advancement in technology, labor productivity increases, and this will lead to the expansion of production possibilities, hence shifting the potential GDP from PF0 to PF1. Real GDP shifts from point A to point B. If labor is more productive, firms are willing to pay more for additional labor, which increases the demand for labor. With an increase in the demand for labor and no change in the supply of labor, the real wage rate rises and the quantity of labor supplied increases. The labor demand curve shifts from LD0 to LD1. As the equilibrium quantity of labor increases, potential GDP shifts from point B to point C. So an increase in labor productivity increases potential GDP for two reasons. Labor is more productive and more labor is employed. In conclusion, Toyota's integration of both technology and people has increased their productivity levels. This will lead to the boost of Toyota's revenue, which will ultimately lead to the increase in Japan's GDP. With the increment of GDP, Japan will become a stronger economy.